is a little more difficult for them to tie on. We got our crowd behind us, you know, so that's a benefit for us as well. I think we know what we have to do. You know, we're motivated. I think they obviously know that we're going to come and go at them.
The cool part about having a second leg at home is you get a chance to put it right, and, you know, you start by getting one goal.
The Huskies have lost 7 consecutive games against Oregon, all by at least 20 points. But the Dogs will have a shot at ending that streak when they host the No. 8 Ducks at home Saturday. Keith Price got his first career start in place of injured Jake Locker at Oregon last year. Emotions will be running high this weekend as the Dogs will be playing their final game at Old Husky Stadium before it undergoes an 18-month, $250 million renovation.
The stadium means so much to this football program, but I can't even imagine in 18 months from now when the new Husky Stadium's up, how much more it's really going to mean to this program, to this university. So I'm excited for the sledgehammer to come. The process will be a unique one, but one that I think is much needed. I'm just sitting back thinking, I can't believe come Monday, you know, Husky Stadium's come down.
The Huskies football team has just 4 games remaining on their schedule, but the basketball team season is just about to begin. This Friday, Lorenzo Romar and his squad open up their preseason against Seattle Pacific. SPU shouldn't be taken lightly. They were on the road last week and beat Arizona 69-68 in an exhibition affair.
It's a little difficult in exhibition games sometimes because you don't...